गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज़ गणेश चंद्र भट्ट, फैकल्टी IHM कोलकाता। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस कैपिटल बजटिंग पार्ट 4। द स्कोप इज इंटरनल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न और शॉर्टली इट इज कॉल्ड IRR। लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन द लर्नर विल बी एबल टू understand the internal rate of return method of capital budgeting and calculate the IRR of a project under consideration. Internal rate of return method, this method of capital budgeting is also a modern technique of capital budgeting which also takes into account the time value of money. Internal rate of return or IRR is that discount rate at which the present value of cash inflows equals the present value of cash outflows. In other words, it is the discount rate at which the net present value of an investment proposal is zero. The IRR is the break-even discount rate. A break-even discount rate is the discount rate at which the present value of cash inflows equals the present value of cash outflows. Under the internal rate of return method, the cash flows of a project are discounted at a suitable rate by heat and trial method. Since the discount rate is determined internally, this method is called as the internal rate of return method. The internal rate of return method is known by many names such as time adjusted rate of return method, discounted rate of return method, yield on investment method, trial and error yield method, heat and trial yield method, marginal efficiency or productivity of capital method, and the last one is rate of return over cost method. The decision rule under this method is that accept the project if its IRR is higher than or equal to the minimum required rate of return or cost of capital of the company, and reject it if its IRR is less than the minimum required rate of return or cost of capital of the company. That means accept the project if the IRR is higher or equal to the cost of capital of the company, and reject the project if the IRR is less than the cost of capital of the company. Now, difference between net present value method and internal rate of return method. The left hand side represents the net present value method and the right hand side represents the internal rate of return method. The first point, the net present value is the difference between the present value of cash inflows and present value of cash outflows. Thus, the net present value may be positive, negative, or even zero. On the right hand side, internal rate of return is that discount rate at which the present value of cash inflows equals the present value of cash outflows. Thus, at IRR, NPV is always zero. It can be positive, but it cannot be negative. Second point, under this method, interest rate is a known factor. NPV can be calculated with only when the interest rate or discount rate is known to us. On the other hand, under the IRR method, the interest rate is an unknown factor. It is to be determined by heat and trial method. Point number 3, reinvestment of funds in the new projects is assumed to be done at the cutoff rate or discount rate in case of NPV method, whereas in case of IRR method, the reinvestment of funds in the new projects is assumed to be done at the IRR. Point number 4, the calculation of NPV is easier than that of the IRR, whereas the calculation of IRR is quite tedious. Now, the calculation of internal rate of return. How to calculate the internal rate of return in case of a project? IRR is calculated under the following two situations. Situation 1, when the cash inflows are equal over the life of the asset. Under this situation, there are a number of steps to be followed. Step 1, first you calculate the PV factor by applying the formula. PV factor is equal to initial investment divided by annual cash inflow. When we divide the initial investment or initial cash outlay of a project by the annual cash inflow, then the resultant figure is called PV factor. Now, step 2, after calculation of the PV factor of a project, now you are required to refer to the present value of annuity table and find out the rate at which the calculated PV factor is equal to the present value given in the table. This will be the IRR. If it cannot be found out directly, then find out the range in between the PV factor lies and go for the next step. Step 3. Prepare a statement of present value of cash inflows considering both the higher and lower trial discount rates in the given range. For example, this is an abstract of the present value of annuity table of rupee 1 for n years. There are so many discount rates given, starting from 12% up to 21%. The number of years are given, starting from first year to year 8. Suppose in our given range, the PV factor lies in between 19% and 20%, which is highlighted in red ink. Suppose the life of the project is 5 years. In the line of 5 years, in the column 19%, the value is coming 3.05763, whereas in the column 20%, it is coming 2.99061. This is an example, an abstract for your understanding about the present value of annuity table. Now, step 4, apply the following formula to get the IRR. IRR is equal to A plus C minus O divided by C minus D into B minus A, where A is equal to discount rate in the low trial, B is equal to discount rate in the high trial, C represents the present value of cash inflows in the low trial, D represents the present value of cash inflows in the high trial, and O represents the original cost or initial investment. For example, if the PV factor of 3 lies in between 19% and 20% discount rates, then the discount rate in the low trial is 19, whereas the discount rate in the high trial is 20. That we have already discussed in the given example or abstract of present value of annuity table. Now, an example: a project involves an initial investment of rupees 60,000. The annual cash inflow is estimated to be 20,000 for 5 years. Find the IRR of the project. Now, by following the steps discussed, in the first step we are required to calculate the PV factor. The PV factor is to be calculated by applying the formula initial investment divided by annual cash inflow. Our initial investment in the given question is 60,000 rupees divided by annual cash inflow, which is given 20,000 rupees. After division, it is coming exactly 3. Now, the PV factor calculated is 3. In the second step, by referring to the present value of annuity table, it is found that the PV factor lies in between 19%, which is 3.05763, and 20%, which is 2.99061. Again, come to the abstract of present value of annuity table. Here, the 19% value in the line of 5 years, in the line of 5 years, the 19% value is 3.05763. Again, in 20% discount rate, in the line of 5 years, the value is coming 2.99061. In the next step, we are required to prepare a statement of present value of cash inflows by taking into account both the 19% and 20% discount rates. In this statement, there are 6 columns in total. First column represents the year, second column represents the cash inflows of the project, third column represents the PV factor at the rate 19%, fourth column represents the present value of cash inflows at 19%, fifth column represents the PV factor at the rate 20% discount rate, and the last column represents the present value of cash inflows at 20% discount rate. Number of years given is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 years. The cash inflows given per year is 20,000. That is remaining same for all the years, 20,000, 20,000, 20,000, 20,000 and 20,000. The PV factor at 19% discount rates has been extracted from the present value of rupee 1 table, that is 0.840 for first year, 0.760 for second year, 0.593 for third year, 0.499 for the fourth year, and 0.419 for the fifth year. Now, the present value of cash inflows at 19% discount rate will be calculated by multiplying the cash inflows by the PV factor. When we multiply the cash inflow for the first year, which is 20,000, by its PV factor, which is 0.840, it is coming 16,800. Similarly, for the second year, the present value of cash inflow at 19% discount rate is coming 14,120. For third year, it is coming 11,860. For fourth year, it is coming 9,980. And for fifth year, it is coming 8,380. Now, the PV factor at the rate 20% discount rate, the values given 0.833 for the first year, for second year it is 0.694, for third year it is 0.579, for fourth year it is 0.482, and for fifth year it is 0.402. Similarly, the present value of cash inflows will be calculated by multiplying the cash inflows per year by its PV factor. When we multiply 20,000 by 0.833 PV factor, the present value is coming 16,660 for the first year. Similarly, for the second year, 20,000 into 0.694, it is coming 13,880. For third year, it is coming 11,580. Fourth year, 9,640. And for fifth year, it is coming 8,040. Now, we will calculate the total present value both at 19% and 20% discount rates. The total present value is coming at 19% discount rate is 61,140, whereas in case of 20% discount rate, the total present value is coming 59,800. Now, IRR can be calculated by applying the formula A plus C minus O divided by C minus D into B minus A, where A is equal to discount rate in the low trial, which is 19, B is equal to discount rate in high trial, which is 20, C is equal to present value of cash inflows in the low trial, which is 61,140. D represents the present value of cash inflows in the high trial, which is coming 59,800. And O represents the original cost or initial investment of the project, which is given 60,000. After substituting the values, the IRR of the project can be calculated as shown in the picture. IRR is equal to 19 plus 61,140 minus 60,000 divided by 61,140 minus 59,800 into 20 minus 19. These are the values which we have substituted. That is coming 19 plus 1140 divided by 1340 into 1. That is coming 19 plus 0.851, which will be 19.851. 8.51%. This is the IRR of the project, 19.851%. Now, the second situation, when the cash inflows are unequal over the life of the asset, that means the cash inflows of the project if are not uniform over the life of the asset, then the situation 2 appears. Under this situation, a number of steps to be followed. First, where cash inflows are unequal, the IRR is calculated by trial and error method. In such case, we start with any assumed discount rate and find out the present values of cash inflows and cash outflows by referring to the present value of annuity table. The emphasis should be given here, we will refer to the present value of annuity table. Then the present value of cash inflows is compared with the present value of cash outflows. The discount rate at which the present values of cash inflows equals the present value of cash outflows is the IRR, that is the internal rate of return. Several discount rates may have to be tried until the appropriate discount rate is found out, that is the rate at which the present value of cash inflows equals the present value of cash outflows. Let's sum up the lesson. The key points are, the internal rate of return is that discount rate at which the present value of cash inflows equals the present value of cash outflows. In other words, it is the discount rate at which the net present value of an investment proposal is zero. The IRR is the break-even discount rate. The IRR method of capital budgeting is also a discounted method of capital budgeting, which also considers the time value of money, like your net present value method and profitability index method. The internal rate of return method is known by a number of names, like time adjusted rate of return method, discounted rate of return method, yield on investment method, trial and error yield method, heat and trial yield method, marginal productivity of capital method, etc. Next, under the IRR method, the decision rule is that if the IRR is more than the firm's cost of capital, which is the minimum required rate of return, then accept the project. If the IRR is less than the firm's cost of capital, then reject the project. IRR is calculated under the two situations that we have already discussed. Situation 1, when the cash inflows are equal over the life of the asset. Situation 2, when the cash inflows are unequal over the life of the asset. And all the steps under both the situations we have already discussed. Here is an exercise for you, which is given as homework. The question is that a hotel has to select one of the two mutually exclusive projects, project A and project B. The details regarding these two projects are as follows. The original cost, that means the initial cash outlay or the initial investment amount for project A is 1,10,000 and that of project B is 1,00,000. Cash inflows for 4 years given, year 1, year 2, year 3 and year 4, for project A 60,000, 20,000, 10,000 and 50,000. for project B 10,000, 10,000, 20,000 and 10,000. Using the IRR method of capital budgeting, suggest which project is preferable and why. You are required to refer to the present value of annuity table of rupee 1 for your IRR calculation. This question is based on the situation 2, the steps we have already discussed. You try your best to solve the question given. It is heat and trial basis. You will have to solve or you will have to calculate the IRR of the projects. There are some reference book I would like to suggest for you. Along with this lesson, you are required to follow these books. You are required to refer these books for your better understanding. Hope you have enjoyed the session today. We will meet again in the next session with a new topic. Thank you.